Well, hopefully, this time I'm not going to get orbed, I hope.
Oh, I smell orbital.
Eh, maybe not. Oh. Alright, so, in this video, I'm going to tell you what Rockstar should do to make the orbital cannon balanced. Now, I know a lot of people are going to disagree with me, but I think the orbital cannon should stay in the game. And the main reason for that is very simple. The orbital cannon can be a lot of fun.
Where are you, Proto?
Yeah, it's safe, he's not going to obliterate us. You can also dodge the orbital cannon, which is pretty funny as well. For instance, in this clip, I was fighting this griefer to get some content.
Holy shit!
But then this big GTA YouTuber called Griefer for Life came in my lobby and started to grief me for absolutely no reason while he was streaming.
It became personal with me.
Of course, I started to kill this filthy tryhard to teach him a lesson. But then he teleported inside this facility to get his kill back. Unfortunately for him though, as you can see, he failed to warn me.
Dude, I'm gonna be orbing. Did he just dodge that? Lol, you dodged it, didn't you? Are you under the ground? Yeah, you job TP'd, didn't you? You job TP'd, didn't you?
Of course, there are a lot of different ways to dodge the orbital cannon. But the point that I'm trying to make is that the orbital cannon can be a lot of fun, and that's why it should not be removed from the game. It just needs to be implemented in the game correctly, which is absolutely not the case right now. So, how to make the orbital cannon balanced? And yes, this is possible. Rockstar could absolutely do it. It's actually pretty easy. The first thing that needs to be done is to give immunity to players that do any sort of activity in free mode. Let's say you're doing a nightclub cell mission, a bunker cell mission, some CEO work, some agency work. If you're doing any of these, it should not be possible to orb you. You should be fully protected from automatic and manual targeting as well. I don't have anything against griefing, if you want to grief, go ahead. But you shouldn't have the ability to destroy somebody's cargo with the orbital cannon. That's just fucking stupid. Alright, the second thing that needs to be done. When you get obliterated, do not spawn at the hospital. This is something that happens to me all the time. Let's say you're fighting multiple people, but they cannot kill you because they suck ass. So basically, one of them is going to orb you, while the others are going to be waiting for you at the hospital. There is absolutely nothing you can do against this. The only thing you can do is to go passive, because fuck you. When you get obliterated, you should spawn back inside the vehicle that you were using. So for instance, in this clip, I was using a Starling. I should spawn back inside the Starling at the exact same location. And there should be a cooldown, a 30 seconds cooldown, that will make me transparent. That will be the same cooldown that you get when you enter an armored vehicle in passive. So basically, for 30 seconds, you cannot shoot, but you cannot be shot at either. If it was like this, it would give you more than enough time to prepare yourself if you have to deal with multiple people jumping you right after you get obliterated. Again, this is a very simple fix, Rockstar could do it. Alright, the third thing that needs to be done. There needs to be a cooldown on the victim. If you get obliterated, it should be possible to get obliterated again for at least an hour. That will fix a lot of problems. It will fix the problem of having multiple people try to orb you. Again, this happens to me absolutely all the time, this is a massive pain in the ass. It will fix the problem of most GTA streamers that are getting obliterated absolutely all the freaking time, which is insanely annoying as well. Just ask your favorite streamer, see what he says. That will also fix orb spamming. If there is a cooldown on you, you can only get orbed once every hour and that's it. So orb spamming will no longer be an issue. Now, apparently Rockstar is going to make a change in the Mercenaries update. If you miss with the orbital cannon, apparently you won't be able to use it again. That's a very good thing. At least if you dodge the orbital cannon, That means that you're going to be safe. It should also prevent orb spamming, I hope. But this is not going to prevent multiple people from using the orbital cannon against you. Again, this happens to me all the time, I hate this. Adding a cooldown on the victim would be a much, much better solution. Gillymaster also suggested this for quite a while, actually. And he's absolutely right about this. Alright, next. Off-the-radar abilities should also protect you from getting obliterated. For instance, let's say you go out of sight. It should not be possible to orb you. If you use the stealth ability of the Akula, the Annihilator, the Ultralight, or even the Alconost, it should not be possible to orb you either. This is also a very simple fix, and you will have a reason to actually use some of those vehicles. Alright, the last thing that needs to be done, the orbital cannon should not count as a score. It's not really needed, but the fact is, a lot of people do care about the score in this game. And if you kill them once, they will try to get their kill back with the orbital cannon, which is dumb. So basically, you take that away from them. That will piss off a lot of orbital warriors for sure. And that's it. Follow those 5 easy steps, and the orbital cannon will be pretty balanced. I know this is hard to believe, but yes. Anyway, I might make other videos like this one about other things in the game that also need to be balanced. If you want to see more videos like this, let me know in the comment section.